Whether you realize it or not, every decision you make is based off of an internal or external system that your brain relies on to save its energy throughout the day. One of the first steps to drastically increase your efficiency and lower the amount of decisions that you need to make on a day-to-day basis, thus making things go faster, is to map out a decision-making process into something known as a standard operating procedure. Now, granted, the majority of you watching this video probably know about standard operating procedures and how to set them up inside your business. But the way that you can turbocharge this process is through automation. So instead of having to rely on manual or delegation work in order to get some of these decisions done, you can use software to infinitely increase the efficiency and speed at which these decisions are getting done. There's a lot of different software out there that can help you automate this decision-making process, but in this video today, I want to talk about Asana workflows and how you can use them to drastically increase the efficiency in your workspace. Now, before I dive too deep inside of these Asana workflows and set some up and show you some examples of how we use them in our eight-figure company, if this is the first time you're using Asana or you don't feel that comfortable with Asana yet, I do recommend checking out my other YouTube video I'll link down below where I have a full 30-minute breakdown of exactly how to use and set up Asana for success. So I recommend watching that video first and then coming back and watching this video second. But if you're still here, I'm going to assume that you know how to use Asana or the basic usage of Asana. So I'm going to show you how to use workflows to increase your efficiency. So this is just an example Asana account that I've created here, and we're on a podcast pipeline project. And this is something I created just to show you how we can set up workflows to increase that decision-making process, the efficiency of it, and shorten the time from when we want to interview someone to the interview being published. Because the shortening of that time makes more things happen faster with less work, which is the definition of efficiency. So if we look at the very top here, you can see this workflow button here, and this is how you can build the workflow to automate a lot of these different tasks inside of Asana. So I'm gonna kind of scroll over on the high level and show you what it looks like, and then we're gonna start building some workflows on our own. So the first thing is how tasks are being added to the project. And then you can see here that there's these different sections in which you can add automation to when something gets added to that section. So on a very high level, for example, whenever an interview gets complete, maybe we want to add a subtask so that we know to upload the interview to a Google Drive folder. So whenever a task gets moved to the interview complete section, then we want to add the subtask upload to Google Drive folder. And let's say that we want to make sure that we do it on the same day that the interview is moved to complete, because we want to make sure we're being as efficient as possible. So I'm going to say the task is due in 0 days, which means that it's due today. And then I'm going to say that I want the person assigned to this task to be me, because I'm the person that's uploading this information. I'm the person that's interviewing the person, and so I have all the content. So if I click on create rule on the bottom right-hand side here, and you can't actually see it because of the way this is, but there says create rule, and then I go back over to the actual board itself. When I move someone over to interview complete, just to show you on a 30,000 foot view, it says that there's a rule being run, and now you can see that the subtask upload to Google Drive folder has been added today, and I'm the person that's in charge of it. So if I just went over to my home screen real quick, you can see it says upload to Google Drive folder is at the top here, and that way when I log into Asana every single morning, I can see that that's the first thing that I need to do. So now that you have an idea of how the workflows work, let's go through some examples of how to set one up and when and why you would set one up. So let's go back to the workflow dashboard here, and let's just click on the to be interviewed section. So what you can do is you can see when task is moved to this section, what would happen automatically. And there's assign task, assign collaborators, add to another project, run app actions, set a due date, add a comment, complete the task, add approvals, add subtasks, and then there's even custom actions after that. So when I click into one of those, it pulls me even deeper into the Asana workflow space. And you can see here, once again, whenever this is moved to the interviewed section, what do we want to do? So a few things before we set up this rule. The first is that I do recommend starting to change the names of these rules, or else it's going to be very confusing when you have multiple rules running on this same section. So for example, if I had moved to section to be interviewed, but let's say I had multiple people interviewing people, I would want to make sure each zap was specific for each person. So I could say something like Ravi pipe, move to section to be interviewed, right? So that way I know that for all of the, for this Zap will run for all the people that I'm personally interviewing versus let's say someone named Jack who's he's interviewing. So you can see it says task move to a section right here. And instead of making sure that every single task that moves to the section fires this rule, remember we actually wanna add that whenever the assignee is also, in this example, Ravi. So in this example here, I want them to, this rule to fire whenever a task is moved to the section to be interviewed and it's assigned to me. Because if it's assigned to Jack, we need to have different set of rules that are running because he's gonna be the one uploading that information. So when all of these triggers happen, when the task is moved to a section and it's assigned to Ravi, then we want to add an action. But of course, you can say when any of these triggers happen, so either when something's moved to a section or it's assigned to Ravi, then do this action. But we don't want to do that because that's not the actual thing that we're trying to set up here. So we're going to go back to when all of these things happen. So when someone is moved to be interviewed and it's already assigned to Ravi, then we're going to run an action, which is on the right-hand side here. And let's say we want to do the same one that we talked about before. We want to add a subtask. So we're going to say create new subtask. And maybe if this is someone that is to be interviewed by me later on, we want to send over the podcast questions beforehand. So send podcast questions, right? So I'm going to type that out here. And then I want to make sure we do it same day because we're doing as efficient as possible. So I'm going to say task is due in 0 days. Or if I wanted to give myself a little bit of leeway, I might add the date range of, you know, 4 days to 14 days. So that would give me a lot of leeway, but I don't actually want to do that. I want to do it in 0 days. So I want to do it the same day that it's happening. And then I want to add in the person that this is going to be tagged to. And this is what the important part about making sure that this is only firing for Ravi's podcast, because then I can make sure that I'm the one tagged. If this was firing for Jack's podcast, well, then Jack would be the one tagged instead of me. And I don't want to do that. I want to make sure this is one is for me only. So I'm going to assign it to Ravi Abuvala, and then I can click on create rule right here. So now we have a rule that whenever somebody is moved over to be interviewed and I'm the person that's interviewing the person, then the subtask is created to send them the questions beforehand, okay? So let's go back over to the board. And if I move over to be interviewed, I actually don't currently have this task assigned to anybody. So just to show you how this logic works, if I move them over to be interviewed, the Zap should not run. I'm sorry, the automation should not run as it didn't here, as you can see, because there is no assignee. I'm not the one assigned to it. Let's go back over to interview complete and let's add me as an assignee over here. So let's say Ravi Val is the assignee. And now when I move it over to be interviewed, it should now add the additional subtask. So there's two subtasks, boom, three subtasks now. And it says send podcast questions beforehand. So because I was the one tagged on there, then it ran the rule, right? Then it ran the workflow. And you can see these little Zap kind of bolt icons right here. That lets you know that there is rules for this section. And this is where you can easily add rules. And you can see why it's important to make sure you name them correctly, because it can get kind of confusing when you have 5, 10, 15 rules per each section. And I want to end this video by showing you what this looks like live in action inside of an Asana workspace that has over 35 team members in it. So just to show you kind of our insights here, we have 35 people inside of this Asana workspace and we have over 30,000 tasks that happen every single 30 days. And that's only increasing. So imagine trying to do all of those tasks manually. It would be kind of a nightmare, which is why we have all of this automation through the workflows. So if I go back to the exact same pipeline, podcast pipeline, but inside an active workspace like we're using here, you can see almost all of these different sections here all have different rules for those sections. So for example, whenever we get a new podcast application, we're actually sending a channel message to Slack, letting our creative director know, hey, you do have a podcast application and you need to be reviewing it. So this is what it says right here. This is their Slack workspace username. You have a new podcast application to review. So that way our creative director doesn't have to go inside of Asana to see that they have someone to review, it's notifying them inside of Slack. Another example could be booking confirmed. So once something is confirmed, then we and they're moved to this section, then there's two main subtasks that need to run. There's a photo and video waiver sign. So we need to make sure that the person is signing the photo and video waiver so we have the rights to publish their content online. And then I'm reminded that I need to upload the podcast footage because at this point, I'm the only one doing podcast interviews. And whenever I'm done with the interview, this reminds me on here, hey, wait, they can't move on to the next stage until they have uploaded the podcast footage. If you have any additional questions around Asana or the workflows, make sure to comment them below.